Hello, I'm Eric Bolt, Warning Coordination Meteorologist with the National Weather Service in Oxnard, California. Let's take a look at the latest El Nino Southern Oscillation measurements and answer the question of what the rainy season might look like here in Southwest California. As we know, last winter's rainfall totals were a big disappointment across Southern California, even though a strong El Nino did occur. Some improvement in the statewide drought occurred across northern areas, but the drought remains exceptional across most of the central and southern sections of the state. So let's get to the latest conditions and predictions for this upcoming winter season. Will it be an El Nino or La Nina? The monthly sea surface temperature anomalies have turned cooler across the eastern tropics, as outlined by the black rectangle box on the map. This is a La Nina signature for sure, but is it strong enough to survive into the winter? Note that in many areas of the far northern Pacific Ocean, temperatures remain well above normal. The computer models suggesting where the El Nino Southern Oscillation will go this winter show that by this fall and winter, the overall average of the 25 models, shown by the heavy black line, would be a borderline La Nina event, or even in the neutral category. The human consensus is that the ocean's atmospheric response is not in sync, and the eastern Pacific Ocean is slowly beginning to warm again. Therefore, ENSO neutral conditions are predicted this winter. At this time, the confidence level of neutral conditions is around 55 to 60%, but there remains a 35 to 40% possibility of a weak La Nina yet this year. Historical rainfall data for past ENSO episodes going back to 1950 show that Southwest California, or Climate Division 6, outlined in the red, has had a wide range of precipitation totals during the winter rainy season of October through March. The ENSO neutral events are the green dots, with the mean amount of 15.5 inches shown by the dashed green line. The majority of neutral events have resulted in below normal rainfall, but it would be hard to rule out the possibility of above normal rainfall based on history. The last time we had above normal precipitation in Southwest California was in the 2010-11 season during a strong La Nina, the isolated blue dot on the upper right. The official forecast for the winter months of December, January, and February continues the theme of above normal temperatures over Southwest California. The last 5.5 years have been the warmest on record since the late 1800s for this region. And here is the precipitation forecast for the winter season. As you can see, there is no clear predictor for rainfall probability over Southwest California shown by the forecast of equal chances of being below, above, or near normal this winter. Here are a few things to remember as we get prepared for this winter season. Even during a drought, it only takes one intense downpour to rapidly create mud and debris flows near recent burn areas. An example of this is the October 2015 storm near the Powerhouse Fire. A series of storms with embedded thunderstorms typically brings a higher threat of flooding to Southern California, especially when we don't have time to dry out between storm systems. We often refer to this as an atmospheric river, or you may remember it as a pineapple express. Finally, a neutral ENSO could be wet, but the odds favor a below normal rainfall outlook for Southern California this winter. Thank you for watching this video. You can send comments or questions to the contact listed, and please check out our weather forecast at weather.gov/Los Angeles and follow us on the social media channels below.